This should be really good against Warrior. The one damage tower isn't as good as some things could be, but it should not be an issue at all. Like, just one. I kept the Shredder, it's very good against Warrior. Tough turn. I guess I'll give him the armor. Doesn't make sense not to. I still get like one damage on this guy, he gets one extra armor. I actually take one less damage as well. Definitely scare the weapons, but it depends what I get. I can get lucky and still get some nice stuff, so. Maybe even a 3-2. 2-3, not quite as good as a 3-2 here. We'll have to do, though. Let's play this matchup slow. Attacking here because this guy is gonna get some weapon down anyways. It's a big difference, the breakpoint 1-1 here. If he goes Beltrade, he gets to protect his dude from my Silverhand, but it actually weakens him to some things as well. Like, for example, my True Silver if he leaves it up. Bomb Lobber. That seems way less scary than Belcher in this situation. I guess it's because he only bomb lobbered a 1-1 effectively. The 3 is enough to deal with any of these minions anyways compared to a lot of those 5. The only problem is Black Knight. I guess I just shouldn't start playing around Black Knight from the start. Especially seeing bomb lobber, I'm not sure if, you know, maybe he doesn't have Black Knight in his deck. I think the Bomb Lobber lists I've seen don't run Black Knight. I've even seen a Bomb Lobber list with like one Antique Healbot, two Bomb Lobbers, or something like that. Question is, I don't want to save this for Sylvanas or for this guy. We'll see though. I mean, I have Boom, so probably just gonna play Boom. I do have some nice moves that don't involve Boom, such as Elder Peacekeeper, the 4-4, 4-3, silence the other guy, and then make a dude. The dude is vulnerable to this one too. Oh well. Boom is just good. My next turn is pretty locked in, muster quarter. Like, there's almost nothing that'll happen where I don't muster quarter. So, it's not really that. Like, the boom bot. If it misses that guy, I can just muster and attack the 1-1 Acolyte. It's like a nice target as well. That's Thor's boom bot's possible. But at least I don't get BJ'd. It does make a muster quarter kind of awkward as well. It's even kind of tempting to go Knife Juggler muster because I'll probably ping these two down, but the 3-3s contest this really well anyways, and in the quarter as well, the 2-5s also get here. The only problem I'm scared of is if he goes Alexstrasza and then hits me for 6, I'm at 9, and I don't really have any taunts. It's kind of weird. Knife Juggler has some better chance of clearing it out. I don't think I can play around it too much though. I've been seeing a couple of decks not even running Alexstrasza. I don't know. Maybe they're running different things like Sneeds. If he's attacking first, it's probably good for me. No Alexstrasza. Alright, so it looks like I deal with this board anyways. It's kind of scary, but I can knife juggler it down, perhaps. Also, I don't have any one big minion right now. Even if I don't kill it, it's whatever. Consecrate sounds pretty good. Three good targets. This is good. This is perfect. This is good as well. Hits a breakpoint. In this matchup, I'm kind of playing slow enough where I'm playing Hero Power every turn if I can. So I definitely prefer a 3-drop and a Hero Power compared to a 5-drop. Especially since like it's not like I'm just running them over with Lotheb. I mean, I have to trade another 3-3 if I don't play the Peacekeeper. My board's actually stronger and I get to click this button one more time. Okay, let's say it's Sneed's Grinder version. The owl is really useful here. How can I deal 7? I can deal 7 with these two, or these two, I guess, and then this guy, the weapon. I can also save two of my 3-3s by playing Peacekeeper. So I would have the owl and then Peacekeeper. I get a feeling I'm so far ahead on board though that that's like committing too much. This card's kind of important. Alright, let's just go and do it anyways, and just not play anything else. So. Should attack a little bit differently. Probably use this guy instead of this guy because 3-3 is worth more than the Peacekeeper because of Quartermaster. I mean, he had the Brawl, but it's not too bad for me. If I get one more ping. Nope. Like the way I'm playing this one, I get to save my Lotheb instead of my Peacekeeper. Because if I didn't Peacekeeper, I pretty much had the Lotheb because I have no board if I didn't play a Lotheb. So it's not really that much worse. In fact, Lotheb's really strong as well. It's like a stronger minion. So I just owl and traded pretty much my whole board. I wouldn't have anything left unless I played the Lotheb anyways, so. Oh no. That's okay, I have equality. Okay, so attack like this, maybe? Then, because I don't lose my dude. And then equality, trade. That works. I can make a little bit of optimization and attack like this, equality, and then start get some pings as well. Shit, okay. No time. I can't rope out. I'm a little sad about Harrison, but it's really important, this D shield right now, this taunt D shield. Okay, force that shield slam. try to get some juggles here. Ideally, I get one juggle. I want to play this shield mini bot in a way where I'm Argusing it. It's like the best Argus target because it has D shield. Okay, I gotta remove that. Whirlwind is a thing. Ideally, I'd save a second taunter here, but it's unfortunate. I didn't really have a way to do it. Like, I could have taunted these two. It would have been better if I knew I was gonna get lucky, but I'm not that confident I'd get lucky. Muster should crush his whole board. So BGH Muster. Actually, I'm not going to Muster here. That doesn't make any sense. So we go ahead and attack like this one. Probably attack like this as well. And kill the Boom Bots. I think I'm pinging. Going to make tokens here. Even if it pings the Dr. Boom. Because I have the highest chance right now to ping a Boom Bot. I really don't want to play the BGH before killing the Boom Bots. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. Wait, recalculate. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Just 14. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh well, let's just go for it. I figure if I hit all face, he's dead anyways. Otherwise, I'd ping down the shield maiden. So he has actually running two Bomb Lobbers and Sludge Belcher. I think I saw this list, actually. On competitive Hearthstone Reddit. I don't think I'm keeping Boom against Warrior, even though it's good. It's a good card against Warrior. One of the things is he might be running a list kind of like what I played against last game, where they're not really running Rag and things like that. And also, you never BGH them before like turn 7 or 8, so you have plenty of time to draw BGH. Okay, this isn't too bad for me. It's way more scared of Armorsmith than Acolyte than Cruel. The double Quartermaster Pallies are so good against Warrior because this is a matchup where like you can actually get value from two Quartermasters very easily. So I can't let him get three cards here, or I guess it might not be three depending on what I do, but I'm just gonna Owl it. Kalenta's deck, interesting. Yeah, I heard Kalenta using Bomb Lobbers in Warrior. He was like telling me about it before. So yeah, I'm gonna prioritize Hero Power every turn. Actually, I should just kill this. I was going to Aldor it, but I realized that I can just kill it really easily right now. Might as well Aldor a second half, depending on what happens. I guess I need to still Aldor it. That's so weird, it's a 3-2. Maybe Juggler Hero Power. Instead of Aldor Hero Power. No! I was scared of having a naked Lothab if I just played Lothab. Because people are running Balm Lobbers now, so that would be really bad leaving up an Acolyte 1-1 against the Lothab. Balm Lobber plus Acolyte would kill Lothab. Okay, I still have my Aldor Peacekeeper. Let's go with that. Try to get one more ping. Well, it doesn't really matter at this point. Kill it either way. Basically, like 5/5s are the best to Aldor. I kind of said this before, but anything bigger than 5/5, you can generally just BGH. So it's really the Shield Maidens and the Sylvanas is the scariest things. People are running some weird, more weird stuff now that like Sneeds. I really like saving Core Master for like turn 8 with the Muster, but I had a Muster turn 3. We'll see though. Oh, Dr. GG. Alright, I guess it's him. This is perfect, I have Curve and Deterian as well. Hope he doesn't have Harrison Jones. Gazlo War? Could be cool. Where it doesn't... I don't know. Haven't tried it. It kind of makes sense for Warrior to be Gazlo. I almost think Shaman Priest for the best Gazlo decks if you really want to use Gazlo. Executed. I think dropping Tyrion into empty board is pretty much the ideal situation for me. Also, it's good to have Tyrion not alone, like because of Sylvanas Shield Slam. Like if they steal your Tyrion, right now it's not an option for him. Doesn't have enough armor, and yeah, that's basically it. Doesn't have enough armor. But I have three minions anyways. I probably don't want to play more into Brawl. I guess I can play Lothab and just go for it, because he can't Brawl. Yeah, that makes sense. So do I want to play Coghammer? Because he can't afford a Brawl turn 10 and not do anything turn 9. So I'm not really playing around Brawl. I mean, I am playing around Brawl because he's just dead if he takes that much damage. The only thing I'm scared of Coghammer is Harrison and Black Knight. I guess a little Coghammer though. It protects me against a lot of weapons. So which main do I have a preference on the Coghammer? Yeah, the ones I want are the two small ones, not the Lothab. Because of Black Knight. It's kind of an awkward one because of the execute. You can execute it through the D-Shield, but this is my Lothab turn, so I'm probably not going to overcommit more this turn depending on what he does. Just land hands this turn. Because next turn he can actually Brawl, but depends how close I'm killing it. Even if he does play Harrison, it's a good chance he's just dead still. Harrison, I still have a lot of damage. Pretty yellow. Oh... did something happen in the last day? This was not yesterday. I actually fought like, what, 65% Warrior today. And before Warrior was like almost a dead, like I never played against Warrior. I guess that's why I'm climbing so fast. I think Shaman and Paladin, the decks I decided to play, are good against Warrior. But this is not something I predicted. I just felt like playing Shaman and Paladin. I didn't realize that everyone would all of a sudden be a warrior. Molly BB Denum 42. Thanks for subbing. Welcome to the Strife crew. Here's a crow fist. Harrison Jones. I like that card. Against Warrior. Paladin is weak to Rogue. That's kind of why Paladin died off that one season. It's because of Rogue. Kind of awkward for me. My whole hand is weird. Guess just make a dude. Can't really justify anything else here. Especially since he has the Fire War Axe. Argus and Peacekeeper just die. Definitely can't justify consecrating a 2/2. Kind of awkward for me. Harrison lines up pretty poorly, but kind of need the card draw. Also, like, everything else lines up weird because he has the weapon. Like, if I go Peacekeeper, it dies to the weapon anyways. I guess True Silver is a thing, but just go ahead and take the value. Bomb Lobber. My worst enemy. I've had a really slow start this game. It's kind of weird. Missed every turn until turn 5, but hopefully we can stabilize. It's okay here if he trades like this. I can consecrate down his guys. I had some options which, like, how to use my other 3 mana, Knife Juggler, Aldor, or even Muster, but I'd probably say Muster for the Quartermaster. It's not bad to make a dude, because if he survives, then he gets Quartermastered as well. Okay, so it looks like this is the best. Get to save these guys from dying. Some people want me to win, some people want me to lose. That's what's new. KT, I do have equality. Zol V just subscribed. Thanks for subbing. Welcome to the Strife Crew. Here's a crow fist. Okay. Ping everything down. I figure my board is so vulnerable to AoE that I should probably not take the 3 extra damage. I'm pretty close to dying here. Even though his deck ring KT, probably no Alex Draza, that doesn't exactly matter since I'm already at 15 or 17 anyways, so. He still has Grom and Cruel and Deathbite, so. That's very well played by him this turn, actually. Because that's really smart. I really like his play. Basically, he might have had Brawl, but not Brawled anyways, because the way he's playing, he has a lot of life to work with, so he can afford to take another round of damage. And the way he's just going face forces me to taunt, and then he can brawl my taunt instead of brawling my non-taunters last turn. I don't know if it's intentional, but I really like that play. I'll just go ahead and taunt, though. I have no choice or I die. I'm probably not going to play more into Brawl, though, and just taunt up the D-Shield guy. So I'm not going to play Knife Juggler. Although, to be fair, I think I should maybe play True Silver and just go for it. Yeah. Get the heal. Grateful Head just subscribed. Thanks for subbing. Welcome to the Strife Crew, Grateful Head. Crowfist. Double Belcher. Let's go ahead and play my Juggler here. Juggler, Belcher, make a dude. I just need one ping on his Belcher for the most part. Okay, so Grom is out of the way. It's kind of good for me. I mean, I do have to deal with Grom still, but I have Peacekeeper. It's a nice pickup, I think. So Consecrate's definitely going down. I think I need to get in the slime form first before Consecrating. Because Consecrating down to a 3-2 isn't that... I have no breakpoint to kill it. So Consecrate, then I have... six more mana. I think I'm gonna make a dude. Actually, let's just go like this. That way I have a better chance of pinging a non-consecrated target. And let's go ahead and make a dude. See what happens. If it actually pings it, I might just go Shredder. He's at 4. It's kind of weird, but it's just the 1-3 at this point. Even if he silences this, I don't think it matters. I have a taunt.